Salutations and welcome to The Gamer's Experience. This is episode number 3 and we're going to be talking about my third game in my PC, Trek Pirates. The game's name is Pirates, but this is the Gamer's Experience. It's me just sharing my top 100 or so favorite PC games in chronological order. I've actually got a live spreadsheet up on Google Docs. I think the link's going to be down in the description. If you want to see what all 100 are going to be ahead of time, you just can't wait for the videos to go up, since I only put these up about every week or two. And I just want to share my experiences with other people. This is not a formal review. It's me sharing my experiences with you. It's less than a let's play, because I'm gonna, but it's more than a review. We're gonna show you gameplay footage, get into the mechanics, really get into meat and potatoes about what made these, what makes these games so memorable to me. The original Sid Meier's Pirates games came out in around 1989, I want to say. That's probably why it's showing up third on my list. It's pretty back there. And the one that I played was originally on my Tandy 1000 computer, and it came on a 3.5-inch floppy disk. And it had very, very basic graphics and the whole nine yards. But it was one of the first games that was really open world to me, and we're gonna show you why here. You really can go whatever direction you want with these games. It is kind of like Grand Theft Auto, except with ships on the water and on a bigger scale. But yeah, before Grand Theft Auto took the world by storm with its kind of open-ended gameplay. I mean, you have their equivalent of gangs and the such, which is essentially the different countries. I'm going to show you the original game that I played in 1989. Now, one of the purposes of these videos, not only to share these old games that I really feel passionate about, but to tell you whether or not they truly hold up today, or if I'm just looking at things through rose-colored glasses. In other words, do I even feel like going back and playing these games today? The original Sid Meier's Pirates is, was definitely way ahead of its time. And again, we're going to show you some really cool things, but it hasn't aged as well. In many ways, Wybarm, the first game I've done in this series, is, if it wasn't for the complicated MS-DOS setup that you have to get into since it's not a GOG game, Wybarm in and of itself is easier to go back and play for me. Thankfully, they've done a couple of remakes. There was one a little bit later on, Pirates Gold, and then there was one really later on, and I believe it was, I forget what it exactly was called, but it was Sid Meier's Pirates. And that was in early 2000-ish or so. That is the game that I would recommend to you, and that's going to be the game we spend the most time on as far as this experience is going to be. It's going to be playing the newer one. But we're going to start off playing the original that captured my heart and captured my imagination, and at the end of the day was the reason why I was very excited when I heard that they were doing that 2004 remake. So let's see if I can find out just exactly when it came out. Let's see, the original Sid Meier's Pirates, and you can kind of see, I'll share the screen here, reduce my big fat picture. That is, we'll make that a little bit smaller there, so you can kind of see the picture. That was the box that I bought. Well, I mean, it's the game I bought, and that's the box it came in. Sid Meier's Pirates by Microprose. Developed by Microprose, published by the same. Originally released on the PC. Later on, there was an NES, I guess, port. But I played the PC, and that's what we're going to play today. Originally released in 1987, not 1989. Woo! So we are going pretty far back. But that is what we're going to play. As I mentioned on the last show, which was Silent Hunter, Silent Service, I should say, much of these games now are available on GOG. GOG, GOG.com. I love that website. It's a great place to purchase retro games. They've retooled them to work in modern-day systems, and as you're going to see here, the old one works just fine. And here is my GOG client. And you'll see that they have Pirates, the Pirates Gold that came out a number of years later, and then finally the last remake, which was Sid Meier's Pirates. and all of them are available on GOG. Pirate's Gold, I'm going to skip over that one. I didn't actually play that one. I have gone out and tried it, and it's cool. It's somewhere in between the two. Unfortunately, it also has a couple of bugs in it still, and it does crash on the occasion. Usually, GOG does a great job of their ports and making sure that the games work in newer systems. I don't know if this is really just bugs in the original game or there's just something that's not working right with Windows. I couldn't tell you. And that's okay anyways, because I was able to put some time into it. And ultimately, because of some control issues and a couple of other things, it just, for me, doesn't make the cut. So we have the old one here for historical sake that we're going to dive into. And then we're going to take a look at the later remake and put some real good time into that. Show you some good gameplay footage. Before we get started, let me show you the instruction book. This is right here in a PDF. And boy, they used to get into a lot of details. This is made by the same people who made Silent Service, I believe. But it is just chocked full of all kinds of information and gameplay tips. Actually, this is the wrong version. This is the newer one, I believe. Let me just double check and see if we can pull up our manual here. There we go. It's got the official pretty art on the front. That's how we know we're playing with power there. And we'll shrink that down just a little bit. Doesn't need to take up that much space. Made by the same people who brought you Silent Service. F-15 Strike Eagle, which I really do enjoy. I did enjoy Strike Eagle quite a bit. But the game that I picked for my top 100 list, F-119. I found it to be a little bit better, and it's essentially the same company, very similar mechanics. So that's the one I picked for this gaming experience series. But these, the early games, they didn't have, you know, great big introductions with animation or lots of text for you to read inside the game. They could only fit so much on a floppy disk. So a lot of the text is right here inside the book. So before you'd even install and play the game, you'd want to sit down and spend some time and read the manual. And it would really help pull your imagination and put your mind into the set of being ready to take on the role of a pirate. So let me read this introduction here for you. It says, "It was an era of new kings and empires, a new test of strength and power. It was a day when a man could rise from humble beginnings and be knighted for brave and daring service to the crown. Now you can be such a man in Pirates, a game of hot-blooded swashbuckling across the Spanish Main. You are transported to the Caribbean, as it was in the heyday of smugglers, privateers, buccaneers, and pirates. All the skills real men needed for survival and success are present in real-time action. In Pirates, you navigate the wide Caribbean by guess, compass, and occasional sun sights with your astrolabe. In peace or battle, your sailing skill can spell the difference between a profitable journey and a watery grave. And if it comes to battle, you must do what a real buccaneer captains did. Lead your men from the front, sword in hand, until you meet and defeat the enemy commander. This is a new type of game, an action simulation. Your game activities are based on how men actually did them, such as sailing ships and dueling with swords. The Caribbean is a canvas of grand adventure, from the treasure-laden ambushes of Sir Francis Drake to the piratical plunderings of the notorious Henry Morgan, whose name still graces a brand of Jamaican rum. Like these men, you can discuss politics with provincial governors, sneak into towns for clandestine smuggling arrangements with local merchants, cross swords with vicious noblemen of all nationalities, rescue helpless waifs from vile slave plantations, even find a beautiful wife. When you accumulate sufficient treasure, land, honors, and satisfaction, you can take a pleasant retirement appropriate to your gains. Pirates brings alive the grand scope of venturesome and bygone age. As in every microprose simulation, extensive research into the details of places, people, ships, and battles brings you unparalleled realism. Pirates goes beyond simple fantasy and touches the reality of an exciting page in history." Ooh, got me all pumped up and stoked. So, yeah, and it really goes into the details as you go through here. It tells you about the different ages, famous expeditions that you can particulate. These are like scenarios that you can play, short scenarios. And then, or you can just do an open game with a fresh character and pick a specific time period and just jump right on in. So each time period features different talents, different strengths, different weaknesses. generally speaking, for a new player, you want to jump into the 1660s, the Buccaneer heroes, where you have more opportunities to plunder and fat cartels of ships on the water that you can steal from. But it gives you a lot of detail here. There's a lot of game mechanics underneath the hood. And again, this is all being crammed on a disc, so there's not any of it really explained in game. You can try some trial and error, of course, to figure some of it out, but you'll be missing some of the finer details on how some of that works. So with that being said, let us jump into our game here with our GOG client and DOSBox. We'll let that boot up and flip into a window mode for me here so I can see my background and the game at the same time. The sound kicks in. I'll probably turn down the game sound because this particular game doesn't sound nearly as good as Y-Barm. It's just configured to run off the IBM soundboard, which is, like one little note at a time. It's really irritating. We'll pick EGA graphics, one floppy drive, using a keyboard. Now, as I said, I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this, and I'm just going to go ahead and continue a save game rather than starting completely from scratch, so we don't take up too much time here. I played a couple of games named Smith there, so I think it's number 2 is the one I want. And this is the screen that you see when you get into town. And almost kind of like an RPG, you got some statistics there, and that's important as far as, you know, let's say I want to go and attack this town. I know that it's got 160 soldiers defending it. And unless I got that many pirates or really close to it, I don't want to make that attempt. You don't want to do a land battle to take over a town if you're not if you don't have the numbers on your side. They've got 10,000 gold though, and so I could steal up to that much from them. Surviving means that they're not really getting ahead too much. If they are prospering, I could expect that gold value just to continue to grow with time. Could visit a governor, visit a tavern to get some rumors and stuff. Get some more men on my side. It says here, travel for a Maracaibo offers to sell me information for 130 gold pieces. This is generally a good idea. You don't have the internet on these ships. The best way you got information was through word of mouth, so you have to pay some of these guys to get some information. And here we find that Maracaibo has 130 soldiers and has 18,000 gold. That's a lot of gold. I don't think I have 130 soldiers on this game yet. I can check my information. I can check my party status here. And I have an unhappy crew of 96 men. They need some more plunder. You keep your pirates happy by getting lots of gold and money. And so having them unhappy, that's not a good thing. They'll start abandoning me. Maybe even mutiny. Here's my personal status. I'm a 25-year-old man in fine health. I've got 200 gold pieces personally to my name. This is not, including the 900 or so that's in the kitty right now. Once I've sailed with these sailors for a while, they're starting to get antsy. It'll be time to divide up the plunder and take a few months off to relax and refit the ships. And my portion of that wealth, which is based on how much we got and split up between the men and how much I got to keep, and that's multiplied by the difficulty level, that wealth gets added to me. So the English have given me a letter of marque, allowing me to go out and attack their enemies and get credit for it. So we're gonna go out here and see what we can do. I believe, let me see if I can continue my travels. Let me trade with the merchant, see if I have anything I can sell here. I don't have a whole lot. Just got some food and some cannons there on the left side. So, not a whole lot to do there. We'll go ahead and leave this town and see if we can find somebody to attack. So here we are in the open sea, and sometimes we'll run. It's kind of like an RPG. You'll run into these random encounters of ships that want to attack you. Oh, and there's that horrible, horrible game sound. So, in 1 second while I go into here and make sure that this is turn pretty far down here. It's really kind of screechy. Now, there is no mini map in this game. That's where it was earlier alluding to, that if you want to figure out where you're at, you need to take compass readings and astrolabe readings, and there's a mini game in the game for that. And you can use that information to help determine where you're at if you can't figure it out through the landmarks. The game came with a map inside of it, which is very handy and very useful when you have it. I don't have it on me at the moment. I'm just farting around with the game. So if I look a little lost... Oh, look, we got a ship on the seas here. We got a French pinnace. They're really fast. They just tend to get away from us. They're small and fast, and they don't have much loot. I need something nice and big and juicy, like a Spanish something. Let's see here. Oh, we got a French merchantman. Now, merchantman, big, fat, slow. We definitely... Dutch. I don't know if we're in battle with the Dutch, if the English are in battle with the Dutch or not. So this may be a bad idea, but I really need some loot. So this is the sea battles, and you kind of turn your ship broadside, and you hit the 5 key there to use the number keypad with these games to try to fire the ship. And I almost got in there, but not quite. Now his broadside's at me. Ooh, and he almost got me there. And you'll see I'll be able to hit him there, and I got some of his men. Not a whole lot of damage there. You can see the numbers where it says right above the word men, that's what speed we're going. We have a lot more men than they do. So really, I just want to crash into them and take their ship over. Sometimes they just give up right away, though. You don't have to get into a fight. I'm surprised they didn't, because we outnumber them like 4-1 here. So you get into this. This is another mini game when you get into a sword fight with somebody. And it moves at a whopping 3 frames per second. And I pretty much just keep slamming the attack button, because I'm not super great at this mini game. Helps to... So you have the number of men that are fighting in the background and what their morale is, and that morale is affected by how well you sword fight. And if you hit the other guy a lot, his morale will go down and yours will go up. And if he hits you, vice versa will happen. And as the battle goes on, we'll lose men based on morale and the numbers. So he's doing pretty bad here. He started off at disadvantage position. So not too hard to get him down on his knees and make him surrender. So you've already seen, like, so Pirates is really a collection of mini games that that work together to create a kind of an RPG-like open world experience. So we've captured 8 gun merchantmen with 100 tons. We have space and hold for 20. So we can send a crew over, and we can add this. This is where the Grand Theft Auto reference comes in, because now I can add this ship to my fleet, and now that ship is mine. And look at all the, 2,200 gold pieces. That's just more than double what I had. And we have tons and tons of goods and stuff like that we can also take with us. We can sell this in the towns. So we want to find a town that has good prices on these. We're just going to take it all. We're going to take their cannons too, just because we can. So that was a pretty good kill. Now, the English may not be too happy if they had an alliance. 3 sailors wish to join our crew? Sure, we'll take them. Well, let me see. I think this is an English town. Not super sure. Unfortunately, merchantman's, having him in our fleet slows the whole fleet down. So, a war galleon. I don't think we're ready to take on a war galleon just yet. War galleons are very tough ships. Let me see what town this is. I want to say it's a French town. Guadeloupe. French flag. We'll just sail in. 160 soldiers, 2,200 gold. And we'll see if they got some good prices on... Oh, yeah, see, sugar, they pay 100 gold pieces. So we take that gold we just stole and we sell it all, because that's a really good price. My background changes every 15 minutes, so... let's see here. We could sell some of this other stuff, too, a little bit of it. I think we'll get some better prices somewhere else, though. Hopefully that food is enough. Now, food is important because it also feeds your crew. If you're out in the ocean for a long time, that will go down, especially with a large crew. It can go down rather quickly. While we're here, might as well visit a tavern. And our reputation's going up as we brag about, things we're taking over. We got some more men who are willing to join us. And there's advantages and disadvantages to growing your crew. Bigger crew means you can take on bigger ships. It means you can take on big towns easier, and you don't get loot that way. The downside is they eat a lot of food. Because the plunder is being divided more between more people, each portion goes down, and all each man cares about is his portion. So morale can take a hit if you get too many men too quickly. And if you only have one ship and it's a sloop, it can only hold like 90 men anyways. So you're kind of capped there. With the merchantman until I've got a lot more space to hold people. But I think for now I'm just going to turn these guys away. Now this old crook here is willing to sell me a piece of the treasure map. So we'll buy the map. And here we see that somewhere near Port Principe, there is a treasure chest right there. So if I had my big paper map here, I would look near Port Principe, look where the land seems to match that shape. And if I take my men there and dig, I could find a treasure chest worth thousands and thousands of gold. So that's pretty cool. You're not going to visit the French governor. I'm not really a French person. Now, I can't do that. I can visit the French governor. It's like it's like Grand Theft Auto and you're playing different factions. And you know, I can get a letter of mark from him. It gets a little bit of a problem if they're fighting my native country and I'm trying to play both of those sides. So here we've got an English town finally. So I'll go in to visit the governor. Hey, Gov, what's up? We are at war with the Dutch. Oh, okay. I thought they were at war with the Spanish. They're at war with the Dutch, which is good because I did grab a Dutch ship, I think, while I was out. So he's going to be happy. There's a little music. Can't really hear it right now because I turned it off. But that's why it's pausing for a minute. It's like, yay, you got a promotion. The governor presents you with an elaborately written royal proclamation, a recognition of your brave and loyal service to the English crown. I gladly promote you to Ensign Smith. I've recently heard news of your long-lost sister, the governor says. The evil Spaniard Colonial Enriquez knows about your sister's whereabouts. He was last seen in Portobello. So one of the little main things you can focus on here is you got lost family members out there. The later game explains this a little bit better with the cutscenes. And you can go and hunt down these people, get clues as to where she's at. I guess you start with your sister. Later on, you probably find your mother, father, who knows. If you get them all, that gives you extra points in the game. And maybe they have some treasure, too. That'd be nice. I never really put too much into that. And there seems to be a little bit of a graphical issue here. This lady's picture is kind of cut into pieces. The governor introduces you to his young daughter. She is presently being courted by Major Howards, but she seems interested in you. So you make pleasant conversation. You can propose marriage. One of the goals in the game is to get married. That gives you extra points. For obvious reasons. Let's see here. We'll trade with that merchant, see if they're willing to offer us more money here for... No, these prices are super low. Now, you might remember, but sugar in the other town was 100 gold pieces. So one of the things I could do here, since I happen to have a merchant ship anyways, I can hold a metric ton, is I can buy it at 30 here, hit enter, leave town. And you just start seeing the possibilities. Yeah, I can plunder places for a bunch of gold. I can trade. I can plunder ships along the way and steal their loot. I can search for those treasure chests. There's just so much. There's so much underneath the hood of this game. It's not even funny. Well, let's see here. Now, if you think they're going to attack you or something like that, they don't like you, you can try sneaking into town, which... I don't really do a whole lot of. If I'm at war with somebody, just avoid their ports, unless I'm going to take them over. So let's trade with that merchant there. This one's maybe the prices have fallen, but it's still I'm still getting a net profit of 50 since I bought it for 30. That sugar over for 30. So 50 times 25. That's a quick. I think that's 700 and or 50 times 25. That's over 1,250. Gold pieces of profit like that. So, not too shabby. Don't know if I want to keep the merchantman, though. Hopefully I'll find something else, like someone will be fighting another or doing a sloop. Here's another merchantman. Oh, English colors. Now, if we fight him, that English governor's not going to be so happy with us. So we're gonna sail away there. Now, one of the things you can do is you can attack a town if you think a town has a lot of loot. I forget if I can save here. Continue travels, party status, ship log. Divide the party. I think that divides them between the ships. Which ships will you leave? I forget exactly what that does. Yeah, this is worse than RPG Random Encounters. Yeah, I think I have to be in a town, and there's plenty of towns right here to save the game, so this is probably a good place to save before I do something incredibly silly here. So, St. Kitts, sailing to the harbor. Now I think if I check my information, I can save my game. So let's do that. This is all played with the 10 key pad for the most part. And the dates are going in kind of a real time. It's like a day for every minute that you're on the, or every few seconds that you're on the overworld map here. So I sail from island to island. Then I'm gonna go up to this. I want to say this town up here is a French or a Dutch town. Oh, we're in Dutch waters. A sloop. Oh, I like sloops. Yeah, I want that sloop. So we can use either sloop or the merchantman to attack. We're going to go sloop for sloop here. And, wow, that sloop only has 12 men. So I could... they're raising their sails. I'm never going to catch up, I don't think. Unless I get a lucky shot here. Because we're going to be same speed at the same if we're going the same direction. We've damaged his sails, though, on that first shot. And now he's lost a mast. So that's awesome. Yeah. Otherwise, it would have been he would have probably gotten away. We're almost the same speed there. And they've struck their colors, so they gave up. They waved the white flag. Now we have a very damaged sloop because we tore down their mast. We'll have to take it into a town and get it repaired. We'll send a prize crew. And not for a sloop. Not too bad on the goods either. 100 gold pieces ain't a whole lot, but I'll take the 16 tons of sugar, especially if they're still buying them for 80. That's probably 1,000 worth right there alone. All right, so we're going to come over here and see if I can attack this town. I think this is a Dutch town. Dutch flag. Attack the town. Now, there's two types of attacking. Talk about mini games galore. If I attack from the ocean and they have a fort, then it's very much like the ship battle, except they never move because it's the fort that's shooting out at you. You can damage the fort. Eventually, you want to touch it, which starts the land battle, starts the fighting battle, just like fighting a ship. If you disembark from your ship first and attack them over land, you get into a strategy game. And that's what I really want to show you guys. And it seems like I can't do that with that particular town because it's just it's taken up the whole entire gosh darn island. So anytime I approach it with my ship, it's just like, hey, do you want to attack by water? So let me see if I can find a town over here that is a little bit more surrounded by land. Here we go. Here's one right here. Don't know what nationality is, nor will I care. We're in Spanish waters. This is probably Spanish. Well, I want to wrap this up, so I'm going to ignore the ship and just get right to the land battle. So you disembark here, and you approach it. Your little men are right there, and you approach it. And it's going to say, hey, you're at San Juan. Three forts. Woo! Well, this is a suicide. I can almost guarantee you that with three forts, San Juan probably has hundreds of soldiers. But I just want to show you real quick. So we'll attack the town. And you can see we have our side over here. And we've got our party split into two groups. Now, when our men are in the trees, there's some tacticalness to this. When the men are in the trees, they cannot be seen by the enemy. On the lower left there, you see Pyre Party, 47 men with 44 muskets. If I press the number 5, I switch between the two parties that I have here. I have another party that only has 23 muskets. Now, as soon as I come out of the trees, the enemy can see me and can approach me. Because he's like, hey, there they are. Not very smart AI, because all I have to do is just dive back into these trees, and suddenly, now they're in the trees, so I can't see them. But suddenly they'll be like, oh, I can't see them anymore. The idea that I want to do here is I want to lure them to my group that's invisible in the trees, because in the trees, you get better defense and cover and all that other fun stuff. So I want to kind of lure them there. But I want to keep these guys close enough to where they can contribute to the fight as well. Except, and if you see that, it shows you right in that lower right corner what kind of terrain they're in. So, wait for them to get a little bit closer. Now, the gray group, the inactive group, will automatically start attacking with their muskets once the red group, the enemy group, gets in range, which should be pretty darn close now. I think. You think they'd be close enough? That's really close. Get a little bit closer. Don't be shy. Okay. I think they just took out a couple of men right there. Let me just draw them in closer to my ambush group, I guess. Alright, now they should really be getting it. So you can see, I mean, they've got us outnumbered, or they got that one group outnumbered 2-1, so I want to be careful in my approach. But, yeah, it's a little tricky there when you're that far outnumbered. The idea is to draw them in and kind of... And you can see, it's just like the ship battle where they all have morale. So our morale is strong, their morale has gone down shaking because they lost so many men so quickly. We'll just sit here and be patient. The AI, he kind of they got shaken, so they retreated a little bit. But you can set up different traps. I think if you have enough troops, you can have actually 3 different groups, 4 different groups. You can get a little tactical with how you do this, but you can only move one group at a time. So that's something to kind of keep in mind there. Looks like they aren't willing to come any closer. They should. They can see me. They can certainly see me. They might just be getting a little smart there. Well, I'm not coming after them into the trees. Now, I can, kind of like ship battles, if I can get to that town without, if I can get to that town and get around their people, I can do that and start a fight with the town directly. So I can try going around like this. Let's see if they'll come after me, though. Yeah, see, now they're getting brave. They're like, oh, okay, maybe we can do this. The really funny thing is you can kind of get them into a pincer attack here. Get them a little bit closer, get into the trees. Then move that other group just a little bit closer down here. And try to move in for the pincer attack, but they didn't quite buy it. They're a little antsy. Can't imagine why. We're going to try to go around them over here. We'll use this other group to kind of draw them back away again. They kind of changes with the new pirates, as you're going to see. This is one of the mini games that they decided to tinker with the formula on. Aha, you're close enough to the trees. Well... I think I've got enough lead here with these guys. They sense something funny going on there. Come on, guys. Come on back over here. This is where the real fun's at. Yeah, there you go. Suckers. Unfortunately, you get close to town, I think it starts shooting at you, too. So, we'll see what happens. Oh, the towns work just like the trees. It hides the people. Come on, boogie, get over there, get into the town. Come on. I might have been wrong about the whole touch the town thing, start a fight deal. Or maybe you have to get both your groups over there. Uh-oh. Well, that might have been a mistake. I'm pretty sure that's how it works. Might have to be getting both groups over there. Might be the catch. Yeah, they just... Wow, it looks like they both killed each other. Looks like I've just got like one group left now. And it says the defenders, there's 54 men left in there in panic. I got 45 men, which is less men, but they've got strong morale here. So maybe if I move this group over here? There we go. So, let's see here. Wow, I thought I wasn't going to be able to take this guy with 3 forts here, but actually doing pretty good. We got them outnumbered. We got them out-moraled. So we're going to see what it's like to take over a town. Yeah, we got them panicked. We got them on the ropes now, boys. There we go. Pretty cool. Yay! The men are all happy. We plundered a town the way pirates were meant to. And now it's at our mercy. The town had warning of your ship's approach. Much of their gold has been hidden away. Now, this is a mechanic in the game. And I'm not sure exactly what drives it. How did they know we were coming? Maybe because we came by land? I have no idea. I'll have to Google that someday. We got 1830 gold pieces. Not a super lot, but there's a lot of goods here, so we'll take all their goods. So, yeah, if they get warning, you only get, like, I don't know, half the gold, a quarter of the gold, who knows? I want more of the sugar. Give me that sugar. Okay. So, now I'm a little bit richer. I got more stuff to go and sell. You get kind of the gist at this point. There's a lot of other things you can do. The world is huge, huge. Without a mini map to show you where you're going, or that paper map, it's easy to get lost. Obviously, we're on the island of, I'm guessing, Puerto Rico, I think is where San Juan's at. But having that map that shows the whole Caribbean area really helps a lot. One of the things about the game is, you know, the winds go from east to west. So when you're going from west to east, your ship, especially if you're doing a merchantman like this, goes incredibly slow if you're flying into the wind, which is more times than not. So you try to do this diagonal thing. You know, try to go cross wind like this. It's nice that the wind's kind of coming from the north there, because I'm heading down towards the south. So I get a little bit a good wind there. And we head back to our English towns here. You can, there is a Spanish armada, the gold armada, that has a bunch of gold that at certain months of the year, it'll visit different places. There's details about that in the book, and if you visit those towns around those times, you can catch the merchant fleet on the dock, and you can make a killing. We will sail into the harbor, and we'll go ahead and save the game here. But that's just a quick overview of the old game. Now we'll see how they jazzed it up for the new one. Let me just save that, just in case I ever feel like going back and farting around in there again. Save game. All right. There we go. So that is the original Pirates. And, I mean, just really capture your mind. You can imagine back in those days, you know, you have your choice between Super Mario Brothers and this. I mean, two completely different experiences. But if you want open world, non-linear experience that's really left up to your imagination, of what you want to do with a lot of different options, and the fact that it handles everything through different mini games. You know, the land battle was a tactical, almost real-time or combination real-time turn-based deal. The sword fighting is a side-scrolling beat-em-up almost, without the Street Fighter combos. So now we're going to do the Sid Meier's Pirates. So before I do that, let's see if I can find some statistics for you guys, right? Statistics. We all like statistics. So Sid Meier's Pirates, now that we put his name in the front, he made them all, I believe, or at least had his hand in them. His name can be found in all of them somewhere, but in this particular one, it's actually part of the official title. This was developed by Firaxis Games, published by Atari and 2K Games. This was released on a whole bunch of different platforms, and I do mean a whole bunch. In fact, this one I'm about to show you, I believe you can even play it on your iPad. I've not tried that one yet. It was on the PlayStation Portable. I played that version, which for the PSP is actually pretty decent. It even says here it was on the Xbox 360, the iPhone, the iPad, the iPod Touch. It was just everywhere. This was released originally on November 22nd, 2004. Now, this game plays in full screen mode, so give me a minute to change the way we are capturing our footage. So we're going to take away the screen there. We're hopefully still recording everything properly. And then we're gonna go ahead and fire up the new game. This just takes a minute. And we'll be able to switch the feedback to the game. So give it just one tiny minute as I flip back over here. And I tell my recording software to capture this game. And this cell. Hopefully. Now I've did this before. And this is my second take, because when I went back and watched the video before, there was some issues. So there we go. Let me change where my picture's at. This being an older game, the aspect ratio is a little different. But hopefully this works. Now, even though the PSP version is pretty decent, given a choice, the PC version is easier to control, and it's felt a little bit easier to get into. I like the last one. I've already got a game of this going, but maybe I'll go ahead and just play this video here for you guys to watch as they set up the story. It began with a celebration. There's no voice talking on this, so I'll have to read it for you. And did it for years at the Marquis de la Montauban. Let me turn up the sound. A family's prosperity was soon to be restored. Turn this up a little bit so you guys can hear it better. Make sure that I've got it up on Windows. All right, here we go. Oops, unfortunately that skipped the cutscene here. Oops, now I'm in character creation mode. Let me just see if I can get past this real fast. Let me try to start over on this. Quit game, or she want to quit. Oh, I didn't mean exit out of the game altogether. No! Well, hopefully the recording software will pick that right back up. Give it just a minute. You can probably hear the music, but there's the video feed. 2K. And it's loading. There we go. So we'll try this again. It began with a celebration. Indebted for years to the Marquis de la Montauban. A family's prosperity was soon to be restored. Their fleet was due to arrive on the morrow, carrying both their hopes and their salvation. Meenoo. But the celebration was befouled by an unwelcome guest. The Marquis himself arrived bearing ill tidings. The fleet had been lost, and the debt had come due. The family's property was seized, and they were pressed into bondage. But one of them would not be a slave. So it was by that brave young Skian escaped his family's fate, swearing to save them and one day avenge the Marquis' foul deed. 10 years later, now grown to his full measure, the young adventurer began his quest to find his family and restore their fortune. So here you create a character, and you can pick, your experience, how hard the game is, and that helps determine how much loot you get and how difficult all the mini games are. Then you can pick what skill you want. I usually go for navigation because I get impatient on the waters, and navigation helps you to go faster. And then your start date. Which is grayed out for some silly reason because I have it on easy mode. If you're gonna play easy, that's the time period you want to start anyways. And then you need to pick your country. Got Spanish, Dutch, English, French. Usually go with the English.
Welcome aboard, Mr. Smithy. We sail with the tide. The crossing was fraught with terror and cruelty. The captain drove the ship and her crew to breaking. Wow, he's a nice guy. Push beyond all decency, the crew mutinies. Free and under full sail, the ship and its crew at your command. You make your way into the Caribbean. A fortune to be had. A family to rescue. Revenge to be served. Your destiny awaits you. Ooh.
Okay. So, let me turn the volume back down on this a bit. But yeah, you can see they definitely give you a bit more to work with to open up the game there. Now, I want to point out, just a little social commentary here, though. First of all, the family was legally in debt, okay? They thought they were going to get that money to pay it off with this ship. The ship went astray, whatever. So they're still in debt. Back in those days, throwing people into prison for debt, that's what you did. So really, was that Marquis really that bad of a guy? He was just enforcing, you know, his rights. I'm just saying, putting that out there. Right, a kid goes, runs off, becomes a crew member on a ship, doesn't have a penny on his name, but then leads a mutiny and kicks the poor captain off and steals his ship. Oh my gosh, how can you empathize with this so-called hero? He's really the villain, but that's okay. I got the volume turned down. Let's get back into the game. So hopefully that's not too loud. And you should be able to hear me just fine with any luck. So let me load up my save game here. Abandon game. Are you sure you want to quit? Yes. Hopefully we can now load a save game. All right. We'll load this one. I believe this is a good one. So at this point in this game, I started off very similar to the last game. Where I started off English in that rough same part of the sea. I captured a couple of ships. I might have plundered a town or two at this point. And so here we are. We're on the water doing our thing. I've got a couple ships in tow. And the nice thing about this version of Pirates is that you can actually see your other ships on the screen with you. And you'll see everything handles a lot more fluidly here. You also can see the enemy ships on the water. So you go from random encounters to something like Chrono Trigger where you can see everything, you know, at the same time. Well, here's a dreaded pirate, Jack Rubberman. He might be really tough. Maybe we should give him a shot anyways. Pirate, Sloot of War. Wow, I've only got 38 men on here. That's probably not super, super wise. Let me see if I can change my flagship here. We got a little sail damage. We can hold 75 crew. We basically need more men. We don't have a lot of crew to spare. So before we attack anything, let's not attack. Discretion and all that other fun stuff. And let's see if we can find an English port. Now, unlike the other game, this one has a great map that you can look at. You can zoom in and out of it, which we're doing here. We can see that Barbados is like the nearest English town. There's also a Dutch town right here. I think in this game I'm at war with the Spanish.
We can actually, I believe, one of these buttons here, fleet status, personal status, captain's log, treasure map, world map. Might be under captain's log. Yeah, we can kind of hear Spanish and English are at war, Spanish and French are at war, Spanish and the Dutch, and there's an English and Dutch treaty. So in this game, I probably don't want to go after the Dutch, but it does mean I can use their ports pretty easily. And if I look at my personal status, we can see... I haven't even ranked up with any of these guys yet. So probably a good time for me to go to an English port anyways. Talk with the governor, see if I can get a promotion. But the mini-map is... there's a mini-map just to begin with. That's awesome. And you can just click on the town, and if you know something about the town, it'll tell you. It says it's an excellent market for spices, so it's a good place to sell spices. If I had talked to one of those guys in the tavern, I'd have more information there available. So let's get over there. And you got your stats very easily there in the lower left-hand corner. Not a lot of gold to my name. 56 crew, they're kind of happy at the moment. You gotta be careful about those storm clouds. They can actually damage your sails a little bit. So that's Martinique over there, that French town. World's End Pirate Haven. Wonder what's here. We'll fly into there. Pirate havens. Pirates like to hang out here, sell their goods and stuff. And you could sick them on, if I was going to go attack a town, I could tell them, hey, go attack that town for me, and that'll soften them up for me. Let's see if we can get some people to join our cause with the tavern. A motley collection of the world's inn's finest have gathered at the tavern this evening to discuss the latest happenings. Apparently, England has captured the city of Caracas. Who would you like to talk to? Oops, hit the wrong button there. And we got 20 men that want to join us. Welcome aboard, mates. You're exactly what we need. We could also use some more gold, too, but... He'll share... Here's that stranger guy from before. He's going to tell us about Argentina. Sure, tell me some more. It's an English town. 360 soldiers. Holy cow. Now, this game also has upgrades for your ship that you can buy. So if I go there, I can give my ships... I can buy cotton sails for them, which help them to sail faster. And she gives me some information about a local pirate, which actually we probably just passed that one up, I believe. He says the governor of Trinidad's a real beauty. Hey, might want to go meet her and try to start wooing her. Let's trade with the merchant here, see if we can get some good. The numbers in this game are a lot lower. Instead of, 100 gold, it's 10 gold, or 2 gold, or 5 gold. None of these prices are super, super great. Well, the 10 gold for this probably isn't too bad. He doesn't have a lot of gold anyways. Let us see what the shipwright can do for my ships here, because we need to repair that little bit of damage there. He could do upgrades too, but I just don't have any money. We need to plunder some people. We definitely need a few more people to be able to plunder the bigger ships. We can put up and down our sails. And in combat, if you want to take less damage to your sails, you want to pull them down, but it does mean you move slower. Let's talk to the governor, see what he has to say. Dear Mr. Jones, please come on in. You may be interested to know we are at war with the evil Spanish. We have a peace treaty with the Dutch. We understand that you recently captured a Spanish brigantine. Excellent, the king will be pleased. However, it's also come to my attention that you captured a Dutch Indiaman. Such offenses will not go unpunished. Well, I guess no promotion for me because I did one good, one bad. I'm pleased to offer you a letter of marque. The nearest Spanish city of Trinidad. Hey, that's the one with the pretty daughter, though. Lies a long distance to the south. In fact, a juicy Spanish ocean bark was seen this morning heading in that direction. Oh, hell yeah. We like ocean barks. Huh. Let us out of here. Let's go get some more men first. Welcome aboard. That puts us around 100. It's a good number to be at for your beginning. Let's see what this guy wants. He offers a rugged leather vest, which will help you handle sword fighting. But it's expensive. We can't afford it. Heck, I want that juicy bark. Screw all this other stuff. There it is right there. Aha. Smash ocean bark. Go get him. For an ocean bark, it only has 4 guns, huh? So you got different kinds of bullets in this game, too. Chain shots, good at taking down sails. You gotta get in closer, though, for it. Grape shot takes out men. So he's got 34 crew, for example. If we change to grape shot and we get a good shot at him here. Boom, knocked him down to 20. Hey, the little men fall out of the ship. That is hilarious. Chain shot, slow him down, take down his sails. Unlike the other game, it won't say sail damage, but you can actually see the holes in his ship there, or in his sails on his ship. As your enemy approaches, or as you approach, the enemy strikes are colors. So no fight on this one. That was a pretty easy taking over. You can see the fighting, or the ocean combat's much smoother. That's why I say this is pretty much the definitive version. Welcome aboard, lads. We got some desperately needed gold, and we got lots of loot. We're going to take all that. We're going to keep that ship. I like having an extra ocean bark. They're good ships. So now we can go back in and just into port real quick and just have this ship fixed. Go to shipwright. Took a little damage to my ship. And then took a lot, did a lot of damage to their ship, so. Let's see here. I probably want to get rid of this little one. The pinnace. It's good for hunting down other pinnaces, but. And it's probably one of the fastest ships around, if I'm not mistaken. But it doesn't hold a lot. And it's extra gold. Oh, they're giving us more money for luxury. Oops. For luxury. So let's give them our luxuries. Oh, spice, 36. Oh, holy cow. Yay, money. Sell that spice. Jeez, I used to think anything over 10 was a good deal. We could use some more food. We want more than 3 months worth. Again, that's based on how many men you got, so. Let's talk to that governor. I sunk a Spanish ship. Maybe I'll get a promotion. The early promotions come easy, so you only have to kill like one or two ships early on to get a promotion, usually. I understand you recently, captured a Spanish ocean bark. But he still hasn't forgotten that Dutch ship I captured. Dang it. No promotion for me. We'll just have to capture some more of them. Now, we have a sloop, the Revenge, that has 75 crew. We got the Bergantine, which holds up to 125 men. And then we have the ocean bark. And the only thing I kind of wish is that the game did a better job of telling you what the statistics are as far as the speed and everything goes. That's kind of important consideration. Showing me how many men. For that, you have to kind of look at the book and read up a little bit, I believe. Oh, you got the Pirateopedia. Huh. Oh, boy, all this game information's right here. Sloop. As you can tell, I haven't really sat around looking at the Pirateopedia. Okay, there's my statistics. Maximum cargo, maximum guns. That's all important information. Is it a fast boat? And the sloops are fast. If you go back to the Pirateopedia here, and look up barks, because we have the ocean bark. I wonder if it has a separate ocean bark. Ocean bark here. Tight turning radius, but a slow speed. Maximum cargo 80. Well, that's kind of good. Let me see. What's the other one? The Brigantine. Let's look at the Brigantine. Turning radius medium, size medium, speed medium. So it's kind of in between the two. It can hold a lot of guns. So definitely want to use the bigger ones for the bigger fights, but I've got all my upgrades on the sloop right now, so that's going to be my flagship for the moment. You can rename them too. That's pretty cool. I've got a quartermaster, which you get specialists that'll help enhance your abilities even further. Like a cook will increase the morale because he makes good food. Let's see if we can get another ship and get into a sword fight this time, so you can see how that works in this game. Very similar. I mean, everything's just based on different mini games. My crew is very happy, as you can see there in the corner. We have a Spanish settlement here. Population 1,400, brimming with wealth. Ooh. Nothing about how many Spanish. I'm going to take this one over. But not before I trade with them. Ooh, holy cow. They want 35 gold. Oh, right. We already sold a lot of those. That's not a bad price for... Oh, he's out of gold. I thought they were brimming with gold. He doesn't have a lot of gold. It's really funny to recruit people out of their town, then attack the people. Attack the town with those people. Yeah, that was... That was Hispanianza. Trinidad are quite low. Just kind of hoping I could get some. Maybe I have to sail further away from it. I was wondering if I click on... Oh, that's odd. I can't get any information on Hispanianza by clicking on it. Get on Trinidad. I guess just the bigger towns pop up. Esperanza is really not... I suppose if I try to attack the town, I wonder. Now, one of the nice things about this game... is you can save anywhere. Yay! The other game, as we saw, you have to sail into your town and save there. So let's do that land battle again. Try to get off here. Whoops. You have to really hit the land far away from the town. Yeah, we'll ankle here. And see if we can engage a land battle here. That might be why they hide their gold, because I'm coming from land and they can see me coming over the hills. 125 pirates just running over. Can I not attack them? It's brimming with wealth. Maybe I can't attack them because... And that's why I can't see stats for them, because they're really just a port, I guess. A French settlement there. Keep sailing. Get down over here to Trinidad. Maybe we'll attack Trinidad. Fortunately, again, you kind of go at the speed of the slowest ship in the group here, and so having that one ocean bark is kind of slowing us down, I think. Maybe I should sell that if I can get another ship. I like having lots of cargo space. I hate running out of cargo space. Buried treasure landmark. You know... So like before, you can buy treasure maps, and I have these pieces I had bought earlier. Rum Reef is here. Looks like there's some treasure down there. So that's what the game is telling me. It's like, hey, there's a treasure map. You got one of those landmark dealies. So it looks like it's to the south of that landmark. Let's just take a look at it one more time. So Rum Reef is up there. It's roughly south and a little bit to the west. And it's south of an Indian totem. So let's go right about here. Now there's an Indian totem. We're heading south. There's the... I think that's the Indian totem. And we're gonna run out of food if we're not too careful there. We only got 2 months of food, it looks like. Your ship is here. Minimap apparently not super great when you're like going on land trying to determine exactly where you're at in relation to the treasure map. And we'll go a little bit further here. I was pretty sure it was just south of that landmark. We're completely lost at this point. Luckily, you can just press that one button to return to the ship. Again, there's the... Oh, let's look at that map one more time. See, it's like you're a real treasure hunter. Look at the map. Rum Reef. It was a little bit to the... west, and I think I was a little to the east because I was trying to avoid this town. So let me go down over here Let's try this again over here. Now, we've got this this man hanging on the... We're almost running out of food. We got that man hanging on that tree there. I don't know if that's the Indian totem or not. It doesn't look like an Indian totem, huh? We'll head a little bit to... Let's try heading a little bit back to the east. This is southeast, I think. Yeah. So hopefully I'm going the right direction here. We can... Oh, that looks promising. That's a geyser. Is there a geyser on the map? There's the geyser. So it looks like it's directly east of the geyser. So let's go to the geyser. And then we'll head east. Wait a minute. Is this compass? There's a red arrow and a... Oh yeah, this isn't confusing. Alright, I'm gonna return back to the ship real quick, get my bearings again. As I run out of food. Ah, good grief. Oh, can we buy food from these guys? We can buy a little food from these guys. Not a whole lot of food. When I first come off the ocean, I'm definitely facing south. Okay, so that arrow tells me what direction I am facing south. I don't know what the red arrow is. There's the geyser. And again, we know looking at the map that the treasure is to the east. So we need to head east. Which, in a way, if I'm going south, and I take a left. If I go south, I'm going towards Florida. And I take a left, that would normally mean I'm going east. But the arrow looks like I'm facing... Oh, this is confusing. Because that arrow is pointing to the east. If I go that way... Oh, out of food. Not good. Okay. Maybe I'm supposed to go this way. This is why you save, boys and girls, before you go looking for lost buried treasure. That. Aha! I think that might be it, boys and girls. Oh, look at that! Woohoo! Rich! Yay! Okay, 2,000 gold pieces. I was kind of hoping for more than that, but I'll take what I can get. We desperately need to find some food here. We are here, Trinidad's over there. I don't think the Spanish completely hate us yet, so we can probably buy from them right before we rape and pillage and everything else to these poor guys. Go ahead and save that before we do something bad. Okay. We do not trade with the English. Aw, you're so cute. Population 1,200. Doesn't tell me how many soldiers it has. Well, let's find out how many soldiers it has, shall we? We'll anchor here. We'll do a land attack so you can see what that battle looks like. Come on, men. The men are starving. Oh, we're about to feed on here. Oh, outnumbered 2-1. Well, let's do it anyway so you can see what the battles look like. So, These are this works off of a turn-based deal, a very simple turn-based strategy DLE here. And it's asking me where I want to start at. I almost prefer being over here because it forces them into the open. Now you have different kinds of soldiers and stuff. You have the officers. You have... let's see here. We have buccaneers, which have the guns. We have pirates, which are your more hand-to-hand combat dudes. Oh, there they are. Let's get into the cover here, boys. Pirates, into the cover. We'll let the pirates get in front of the buccaneers over here. And they take their turn. They outnumber us 2-1. I mean, it looks like they have less units, but I'm pretty sure there's like more men in the town or just more men in their squares. In fact, I wonder if I can click on them. This is an enemy unit. Oh, that's just bloody lovely. So they have horses. That's a different type of unit type. You don't want to face the horses on open fields because that just ends poorly for your guys. So you can move the pirates up here now. Buccaneers up here. And can these guys shoot yet? No. We're just gonna skip our turn and let them come to us. Oh, they can shoot us in the trees. That's not nice. Oh, hey, there's more of them. So, I want to go to my buccaneers for... why can't I not fire? Maybe I have to have a clear shot and there's people in front of me? It's odd. I thought I could fire at least from a distance here. Well, I need to take out these guys one way or the other. Oh. I'm just cutting down my poor little pirates there. Wow, that's that whole don't fight the cavalry in open plains thing. No, I think I'll just stay here. Can't believe I can't fire at these dudes. If I move up here, can I fire at them now? Probably should have read more in the instruction book. Yeah, battle earlier did okay, but probably doesn't help that I'm outnumbered 2-1. They seem to have lots of guns. It's not very nice. Well, they can move and shoot. Oh, yeah. This ends poorly. But see, forcing them to come into the forest, really, it says forest divided by 3. Of course, that didn't seem to actually stop them from slaughtering my men. So, yeah, this is just one of those end poorly things. Generally speaking, you don't want to... Oh, hey, I can fire, finally. Of course, they're now in the trees, so they get cover bonuses. You want to quit your card game, yes. This is why we say, boys and girls. Let's see here. I think that's where... It took us a while to find that treasure. Those days fly by when you're on the ocean and the such. Unfortunately, that doesn't solve my food problem, right? Now, one of the other things you can do is you can sneak into town, which we might want to do here. Sneak in and try to buy some food the old-fashioned way. So let me unpause the game, which is one of these buttons. Maybe it's the pause button. There we go. Mm-hmm. Let's just see if we can sneak into town. Leave the town. Enter the town. Oh, it'll let us enter. They're not shooting at us. And the governor just refuses to talk. Oh, it's the... that's right. They wouldn't trade with us. Bloodsucker. You think he'd want money? Well, he sucketh. Yes, I know. The men are starving. Well, let's see if we can find something that's a little bit closer. Or find somebody to conquer that has food on their ship. Hey. Speaking of... Come on. Come on, buddy. Tell me you got some food on your ship. Oh, no! A single cannonball! We're not even gonna... Whoa! Come on over here. Come to Papa. Hopefully we get into a sword fight here, yeah. So you get to pick your different weapon, longsword, rapier, which is fast, or cutlass, which says solid defense. Usually just go for the quick attack. I like hitting people really quick. And so it does this timing-based. Very similar to the other one, but definitely better graphics. And if you time the defense, you can do... you can dodge as attack and counterattack. And how fast that all moves is depending on the difficulty setting of the game. Yay, we won! Hopefully you got some food too. Not a whole lot of food. You guys suck. We'll take your gold though. We'll keep your ship and we'll sell it at another dock. Oh boy. Let's see. Looks like there's an English port down there to the south. Let's go over to that one. English settlement. Well, hopefully it's an English settlement with food. Trade with the merchant. I'll take what little food you guys have. You guys suck. You need more food. Repair our ship. Repair. We could probably, I don't know, probably get rid of this. Catalina bark. Ocean bark. Probably get rid of one of these barks. Extra gold. Let's see what the mayor has to say. I've been appointed as the new governor of Caracas. I was wondering why there is an English town down here in the southern part of the land. Usually it's all Spanish, but it's because they just took over. Oh. Oh, he wants an escort to Caracas. Oh, that's pretty funny. Well, sure, why not? These are the kind of little things. This is like Grand Theft Ship. It's a little side quest here. Why not? I'm sure that'll just give me more English points. We'll check the tavern, see if there's somebody who wants to... See, he'll tell me information about my family for 1,000 gold, but that's a lot of money that I just don't have right now. Gotta keep the men happy, gotta keep some loot. Alright, let's get this guy to where he wants to go. At least we got, oh my goodness, at least we got, some food. I can't seem to get out of this port. Huh. There's a... The map seems to be a little messed up here. Ooh, can we say glitch, boys and girls? Yeah, the game is glitching out. That is hilarious. Oh boy. Divide and plunder. That was glitchy. That was 100% bona fide glitch. Naughty, naughty, naughty. So we're back here again. Yay! Well, at least we know where to go. While we're getting over there, this does a better job of kind of organizing, you know, any quest that you've picked up, information and stuff. And underneath your status here, you can see how many lost relative, how far you are in your lost relative quiz. You're looking for lost cities. How's your romance going? Pirates you've defeated. It does a really much better job of organizing information in the game, whether you're looking for information about a town, what information you've collected so far, what you've done along the way, who's at war. It's just much, much easier to look things up in this version of the game. McCree's very happy because I got 4,000 gold now. Maybe I could afford that 1,000 for that one guy. Who knows? Well, they're not going to be too happy too long if I don't get some food. So we'll get over to that English settlement that was over here, and hopefully the game won't glitch this time as I try to get out of this port. Because all we did was we went in here, we trade with the merchant, take all of his food, please. We're going to let these poor citizens starve. We don't care. Repair a little damage. Repair. Repair. Talk with the mayor. He wants to go to Caracas. Fair enough. Hopefully, game doesn't glitch. Ah, that's better. Whoa. That governor's ship was just flying around there like a butterfly. So we'll just go over there and maybe find a Spanish ship along the way. Where's it going? It's not very fast. I even took down my sails. I have to go in a loop just to... There we go. We don't want to get too far behind. Because he wants to get over to Caracas, which is way over there. Come on, buddy. Pokey pokey. Men are getting hungry. Wealthy Spanish village. Ah, they're firing cannonballs at us. That's not... Oh, ow, 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 ow. Ooh. Dutch. We don't want to attack the Dutch. We got in trouble last time. But that Spanish... The Spanish, whoa, 16 guns, 124 men against my sloop. Now that's a fight. It's kind of one of those fights you want to save before you actually engage in. Yeah, nothing like a good old save scumming. Zooms in on that fight. This is where we probably want to try to cut down their men with a grape chain shot here. Or grape shot, I should say. But that's not stopping them from doing a number on us in the process. The tight turning is helping out a lot here. Just running circles around them. It's the nice thing about the... I like this ship. Miss there. Uh-oh. Nah. You hear the little man falling off. Oh, how did I miss that? Shucks. Down to 4 guns, shoot. Better just close in on him and hope for the best. I've closed the gap a little bit anyways. So this ought to be an interesting fight. Boom, counterattack. Whoop. Don't think so. Oh, I thought I blocked that. Ouch. Oh, he got me there. Sometimes I just go all off and screw the defense. I'm usually faster, especially on an easier setting. I'm sure on the harder settings, you really gotta get that timing right. Lots of money. Got some ship action. Take it all. All right, back to our main quest at hand and getting him back to Caracas there. Almost there. You hear them sing. I don't know how well you can pick up on the audio, but they're singing, yo ho ho, and a bottle of rum. Or it's more like they're humming it. You're almost there, buddy. You're almost there. Hopefully we didn't lose him now. Come on. Put your foot on the gas pedal. Oh, at least those other guys have some food. I don't want to attack anybody. I wasn't trying to attack somebody. Don't think I hit the attack button. Hey, is that a Spanish ship? Indian war canoe. Well, that's funny. Invasion force. I think it's Dutch. Yay, the economy flourishes. They got their new governor. Let's talk to him. Please, come on in. We're at war with the Spanish. Woo! Yay, I finally got promoted. I'm a captain now. And I've got that weird smile going on. I also got some land, because it's all about the land. Oh, who wants a plain daughter? That beat a hasty retreat. That was actually kind of cute. Oh, you can't save in town. So anyways, that's a pretty good, pretty quick overview. Didn't get to show you the dancing minigame. You have to woo a lady. That's a little bit further in the game for that. There's other power-ups and stuff. Power-ups. Like, you can buy trinkets to make your relationship wooing of the woman easier and the such. All kinds of upgrades I mentioned earlier for the ships, the different specialists you can get on board. Eventually, just like the other game, you'll have to divide the loot because the people get more and more... The pirates get more and more restless over time. So, generally speaking, at some point, you got to divide the loot, take a few months off. And you do age. As your character gets older and older, his statistics that are underneath the hood get degrade. So there is only so much time to do everything that you want to do. But, it does a pretty good job of trying to keep you on track and let you know. Oh, you can relive the cutscene. That's pretty cool. Spanish. I'm a captain now in English. What's really funny is they got 2,000 gold reward out for me over here. Sometimes the countries will offer amnesty. And if you go visit one of the mayors there, you can get your record wiped clean. So yeah, the crew's content. Even though I got more gold, they're already the morale starting to degrade. And eventually get so restless that I'll have no choice but to divide up the loot, so to speak. So that is Pirates, and it's a really fun game. It's one that, you know, if you talk to people about, it's already way back in their memory. But it's really a great game just to pull out, dust it off, and when you're feeling like just having the world as your oyster. With too many things to do, really, but you can't possibly do everything in one game lifetime. But this is a really, really fun way to do that, and it's got all, you know, as you saw in here, it's got different mini games to manage, you know, how you handle different aspects of the game. I personally find the dancing mini game, you can probably Google up a video on YouTube of that. I personally find that one to be the hardest, really. That one is tough, and you can actually get a trinket that helps you handle that mini game better and do better at that. And basically, I think it slows her down in her prompts, because you'll be dancing and she'll like put her hand over this way, which means you need to press the left key and move to the left, and it has to be done in time with the music. I just suck. There's also another mini game if you do have to sneak into a town where you have to move on the streets when the guards aren't looking. It's also the same minigame, I think. If you get captured, you'll get thrown in prison for a few months and you'll have a chance to escape. So, another couple of different minigames under the hood. But it's a lot of fun. It's open world. It's huge. And I just can't recommend it enough. And I just had such great memories playing the original and even the new one, of just going through and finding my relatives and finding lots of money and working my way up the pirate food chain. It's relaxing. It's not very stressful until you do the dancing mini game. If you put on the easier difficulty level, if you're looking for more of a challenge, bump it up. And those mini games, they all get deeper, more complicated. So, anywho, we're about to wrap this up. I'll remind you that if you want to interact with me, you can leave comments down there on the video. You can also hit me up on Twitter. I'm at JC Servant. You can email me, jcservant@cyberlightcomics.com. If you like this kind of stuff and you're really into role-playing games, you might want to head over to rpgamer.com. Mike Minky and I have been doing a podcast for years. We're into the 150, 160, something like that. But we do a podcast there called the RPG Backtrack, where we talk about old role-playing games from way back then, right up through yesteryear. So you can go in and listen to the details and the juicy bits. We talk about, we get into the mechanics and everything else. It's this show is pretty much inspired. That is the audio version of this, and this is the more visual version of that. And here I'll do games that aren't necessarily role-playing games, because it's more PC-centric, just PC games, my favorite PC games of all time. But you can go and you can check that out. If you're into more of the theological stuff, I also do, I also did a video series called New Direction about subjective faith. So you can go and check that out. A lot of the details are right down there in comments. Otherwise, I thank you so much for listening and sharing this experience with me. And hopefully you'll be around next time to, I think, the next game. We're going to actually be playing some Leisure Suit Larry. So hold on tight for that. Until then, have a good time and watch out for choppy waters, okay?